My name is Niall, and I'm a friend of Teresa's, and so are ye. We are the Teresa Treacy support group. That's everybody here. It's very easy to be a member of the Teresa Treacy support group. What we want are three things. One, the immediate release of Teresa Treacy. Number two, the undergrounding of the power line in accordance with European standards of best practice. And three, the protection of the native Irish trees on Teresa's land.
We are in the closing months of the International Year of the Forest. An energy company that is possibly getting to halfway being green has gone in with the intent to cut down 12,000 broadleaf trees. We have the smallest broadleaf tree cover in all of Europe. It's an insanity.
I've never met Teresa Treacy, and I've never met most of the people here, but her story really touched me because she's an innocent woman. She's protecting the environment. She's trying to protect her own land against bullying. And I would like to hear from Alan Shatter, Minister for Justice or Injustice. What has he got to say about this? Have we heard from her five local TDs? Teresa Treacy lives in a constituency where there's five TDs. Where are they?
I'm here today because I think it's absolutely disgraceful. That woman is 65 years of age. She's thrown in prison with criminals who shouldn't be in there. She shouldn't be in there. And what should she do? She protected her land, her trees. It's disgusting.
Campaigning and asking the ESB to underground some high power lines that's going through Donegal, and with not much success. And we're here to support Teresa Treacy today. We think she's fantastic.
I've been supporting freeing Teresa since I saw it in the Daily Mail the very next day, and I was disgusted that the judicial system is using the letter of the law to penalise individuals while supporting big business with the same means. This is a republic. They are supposed to be protecting us.
We're not against the power lines, we're not against progress, and we're not against the beefing up and to get a good constant electricity supply to the Tullamore hospital and to the town and to the Midlands. We're not against that. We're pretty well against the ESB, who are no longer the benevolent services provider that they make themselves out to be, but they're a corporate giant. Corporations they're dedicated to profit, and service second. They have to turn a profit here first of all, and it can't be at the loss of a woman's civil rights and human rights to protect her land.
We will all be in prison if we all do not unite and stand and say no to corporatism. ESB has launched Positive Aging Week.
Yeah. Hypocrites.
This week.
Hypocrisy.
If this is positive agingism, I really dread what negative agingism is.
Hear, hear.
We have to switch things around because things are not working.
It really says everything about what's rotten in this country.
That
the building we are protesting outside is the former headquarters of Anglo-Irish Bank, which played such a significant role in destroying this country. It's rotten, absolutely rotten, and it's quite appropriate that the ESB, who are responsible for this rotten behaviour, should be in the same building as the previous gang of criminals who inhabited the same building in Anglo-Irish Bank.
The flaw with the technocracy is that it views the landscape as something separate to us, for us. But we are the landscape. And whatever we do to the earth, we do to ourselves. I call on the ESB to please reapply to the court for her freedom in the same manner in which they applied for her committal.
Release Teresa Treacy. Release Teresa Treacy. Release Teresa Treacy. Release.